and welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. South Florida is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. Fielded at the four. And down he goes at the 24. Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Receiving team.
That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Makes it out to about the 26. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
He gets hit out of bounds at the 33-yard line. The tailback picks up a solid 7 yards on the counterplay. Tackled at the 41. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
He's got it with room to run. Tackled at the 48. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's knocked out of bounds at the 42.
I'm a huge fan of the play-action pass in college football because with play-action, it really puts a lot of pressure on defense. The defense gets caught up and concerned about the running game, and it puts them out of position, and it makes the throwing lanes for the quarterback and the windows that he's trying to find much easier to find for a quarterback and the receivers to pick up big yards like we just saw there.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Hey, let's get them home. Hey, check Mike 34.
Here's a little draw play. He's at the 20. Knocked out of bounds around the 19-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass. Love the toughness here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Runs with it, and he's got room. Brought down right around the 6-yard line. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Touchdown, Oregon! And he adds the extra point. A 10-play, 86-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Oregon lines up for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Gives it off. Tackle made around the 25-yard line.
Second and
It's second and 10. Ball on their own 25. Taken down around the 22-yard line. The defense was all over that draw play.
They had very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
From their own 22-yard line, third down. The Ducks saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. He wants it all. And he tackles him hard to 37-yard line. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Quickly incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play. You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He airs it out. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. So that's a six-play, 76-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute in the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you can move the ball down the field.
He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 20. Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The back gets three on the carry. Nice run, and he's brought down. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. That'll be a 7-yard pickup.
That's a good completion. They didn't get the first down, but they picked up about 7 yards.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Runs it and tackled in the backfield. Taken down at the 49-yard line. First down. from their own 49-yard line. First down. Zips it to the back. They'll bring him down at the 44. So at the end of one quarter, we get a tie game at 7-7. Welcome back to the action. Just about set to start quarter number two, and we're all tied up. They line up in the jumbo set. They go with a run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Caught, open field. He's at the 30, and he's tackled at the 25. First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. They come out in a goal line set. And they make the stop at the 24-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
This is the 9th play of this drive. Tailback brought down for a loss.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
They're at the 5. It's second down. And he makes it out to about the 5-yard line. It's the 11th play of the drive. He's out of bounds, right around the 2-yard line. The offense is staying on the field. It's all or nothing. Here we go. Touchdown, South Florida. It's the PAT. South Florida is ready to kick it away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Makes it to the 28-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. He fights forward to about the 30. He gets rid of this one.
The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. South Florida is up seven. Gets to about the 44-yard line. It's second down, eight to go. Ball on the 44. Hits him hard at the 46-yard line.
That'll bring up third and six.
He's tackled around the 44-yard line.
That's good for being 10 yards.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line.
Ready, red 18.
Good tackle there in space.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Three down.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 24.
Three down. Check 13.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackled at about the 19-yard line.
Good work here by the defense to keep him from making something more out of that play.
Nice play to set up first and goal. South Florida is up a score. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. He makes his second touchdown grab of the game.
You know, this guy is such a difficult target to cover in the passing game. It usually doesn't matter who's covering him. He always seems to find a way to get open and make a catch.
And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
Oregon's coaching staff, I've got a thing going into halftime, and we're getting close right now, Kirk. They've got to do something different. What they had planned with their star running back is just not working today.
Well, I think the continuity between a coaching staff and a quarterback and an offense is tested. Their star player is not having a great game. They're losing this football game. I think now, as we're close to this half, now is when you start to think about what other ways can we attack this defense. And then maybe eventually we get back to our star running back. But in the meantime, let's try to find some other ways to attack and be able to put points up.
From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. He's out to the 30. He did not get to the first down marker. We've played a half. USF leads it 21-7.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back to their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Slings it. Brought down at the 45.
Gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
There's the strike complete. Tackle made right around the 32-yard line. From the 32-yard line, first down. And he might want it all here, and does. It's going the other way. A well-timed interception there.
Well, they're still down by a couple of scores, but the turnover certainly helps their chances. If they score on this drive, they're right back in the game.
He fights forward to about the 23. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
That's the senior safety that made that tackle. Great job of providing run support from the secondary.
And he shoved out of bounds right around the 38-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Some open field. And he's level at the 44-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Nice gain as he works to the right side. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Nice run up the middle. They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
inside the 10. What a play, and that is first and goal. Taken down
right around the 6-yard line.
So they wrapped him up before he could get anything going.
Yeah, there was nothing there on that option.
This is the 11th play of this drive. On the pass, touchdown.
Give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
A 10-play, 79-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
So the score now, 21-14. And the offense will take the field, and they're certainly hoping to do better than they did in their last drive, which ended with a turnover.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Fires it out. And he's taken down at the 34. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. South Florida is up by a touchdown.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
Some room. He's at the 40. Makes it to the 34. From the 34-yard line, it's first down. Under pressure, they'll bring him down at the 34-yard line.
Here we go.
Gains his way to the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, first down. Throw, and he's got his receiver again. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
South Florida up 7 points. Makes the catch, and look out. And he's tackled at the 9. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Knocked out of bounds at the 6. So at the end of 3, the Bulls lead 21-14.
Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Rifles it left.
Not a great throw by the quarterback, but to be fair, that was pretty good coverage.
It's fourth down. This one should be makeable. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And they can forget about returning this one.
So they're just about set to get the game going again.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Down after a nice run up the middle. There was some movement on the line.
False start. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they can just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So the penalty will make it first and 15. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Decent pickup.
Call it a game of 4 yards. Third down.
He makes his way to about the 48. There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. First and 10. Ball on their own 48. They make the stop around the 37-yard line. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. Tries to buy some time. And down he goes at the 28. Just under three to go in regulation. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. He's looking for six. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Oh, my gosh. How did he drop that? The offense has a new life and a new outlook on this game after that dropped interception.
From the 24-yard line, it's second down. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. Touchdown, Ducks.
So they've got this back to a one-possession game. But with the time left, I still think they're facing an onside kick situation.
The draw within a field goal. And he hits the PAT. An 11-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. The score now, 24-21. Oregon ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. Oh, man, he took him down hard. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and 10.
Tight end, right. Go down, go down. Hey, look 48. Here we go. 180. 180.
So not only did they risk an interception, but now they've given them more time. I just don't get it.
From their own 32-yard line, second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. The Ducks taking their first time out of the half. Go back to him on a quick throw. He's tackled around the 49-yard line.
What a relief it is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down.
Nice run there. Oregon's called their final timeout from the 45-yard line. It's second down. At about the 43-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it third and 3.
This is the 8th play of this drive. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Well, you can see the elation on the defensive coordinator's side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this fourth quarter. Under a minute left in the game. Time's becoming a factor now as the offense takes over after the punt.
They don't have to have a touchdown here. A field goal will do it, but they are going to have to do it in a hurry.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. So this is it right here. One last play and one last chance to win the game. If they can get the Hail Mary, they'll pull out the miracle win. He chucks it downfield. That tackle just sealed the deal. So that's going to do it. The Bulls get the victory, 24-21. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.